Ayun, okay. So ayun, good afternoon, Josh, and welcome to our, I think, second to the last session for kinetics. So before we move on with our practice set, Josh, by the way, before we move on with our practice set, we'll have first our review session for reaction mechanisms. Kasi parang too tired ka na nung Thursday, baka ano, hindi mo siya ganun na-absorb. So, but for reaction mechanism kasi, it's very important that you know that you have this strong foundation for chemical structures, right? That's the reason why I'm asking you to draw the structure of N2O2, N2O5, etc. Anyway, before we proceed with that then, using lang natin yung sked. So for today, we'll have kinetics. And then on Tuesday, Josh, and Thursday, next week, you'll meet with Sir James na, ha?
Abo.
That will be another chapter. Wow, another chapter ka na. You're nearing na sa end ng Gen Chem. So, the next chapter will be...
Kala niyo po yung end of the end of the tunnel, pero yung after that...
There's another tunnel. Multiple tunnels na. don't be sad or don't be surprised because general chemistry will lead you to different different fields of chemistry anyway and actually different branches of sciences because this is a very good foundation for biology and physics as well even earth science ka, ang dami naming application eh. Marami-rami kaming overlapping din sa earth science like kunwari yung mga biochemical cycles you'll easily understand them or yung mga composition ng rocks etc because those were being discussed din sa chemistry so applied na lang siya din sa earth science anyway again na today kinetics and then on Tuesday start na yun ang equilibrium Thursday equilibrium ulit with Sir James. But on next Saturday, that will be Feb 19 na pala ngayon, Josh. Feb 26, last session natin yun for kinetics. If we'll finish early sa kinetics, I'll be introducing you some questions ulit coming from the Olympiads. Para at least na-prepare ka dun sa charan! Uy, make sure ha, ready ka na dito ha. March 5, Saturday, comprehensive exam. First part. Do you think you can finish 100 items for 2 hours?
Baka po, kasi hindi, no? Yung ano po, yung kasi, ano kasi, yung kala ko po, kung if I will fail at a subject, it will be thermodynamics. Pero po, na-review ako, so I am stronger.
Wow, yeah. Especially thermoday, no? Kasi at least minus na yung thermoday. So, and today we'll be reviewing naman parang kinda chemical structures, right? That's the reason why nung starting pa lang nung Thursday, nagka-chemical structures na tayo. So, mga atoms na lang ang re-reviewin mo. Atoms, periodicity, IMF, stoichiometry, but stoichiometry and ano nga ito, gases usually, they're integrated na with our solutions, right? And concentration of solutions. So, I think kayang-kaya mo naman na to. March 5, ha? Comprehensive exam. I'll divide our comprehensive exam into two.
Naririnig ko lang po yung term comprehensive exam.
Wait, halfway comprehensive exam. Please take note, halfway. Because we'll only cover chapters 1 to 11. Okay? So in starting chapter 12 pababa, that will be another comprehensive exam.
Yes.
Pero I'm planning also to give you a whole chemistry exam starting from matter down to the last topic, coordination chemistry, before you proceed with other subjects. Okay? Parang to solidify lang everything. Kaya mo yan. Okay? So, actually, pag natapos mo nga ito, malaki na yung parang unlucky na ng chance mong pumasa sa ano. If you'll take the chemistry board exam sa Pilipinas, you'll be passing na yung inorganic chemistry naming subject. They're very, very high chance. And the other subjects, you have an idea na rin. Especially sa PCHEM and PCHEM, kinda organic, pero kakaiba kasi organic. Tsaka analytical. Yan. Sa analytical, makakasagot ka na rin doon kasi equilibrium ang unang part na analytical. So anyway, reiterate ko lang, March 5 will be your first part of your comprehensive exam. So I'll for 2 hours, you need to answer 50 items. Okay? So pwedeng ang ano dito, Joshua, pwede siyang multiple choice, pwede rin siyang you need to input an answer.
When the ano so, pa, when
the calculation.
Multiple choice po yung ano yung savior.
let's see. Pwede rin siyang short explanation or short answer. Okay, so that we can test your explanation skills then. Okay. Okay, yeah, maganda yan para at least iba-ibang klase ng tanong. Mas natitrain ka lalo. Para mag-double check natin yung learning. Anyway, let's proceed now ha with reaction mechanisms. Let's go back to reaction mechanism. So, before we go back sa reaction mechanism, I want you to recall this one. Naalala mo yung energy diagrams?
Opo.
Yung may graph, yung may endo, exo.
Opo.
Naalala mo yan? Ayun, good. Eta.
Yun ba?
Sige, asaan dito, anong type to ng reactions or eto, itong dalawa. Ito may catalyst to eh. Balik tayo dito sa may temperature. Ayan, eto. Recall nga natin to. So, ano to Josh? Endo or exo, yung A?
Sinulatan ko po yung handout, so therefore I know.
Oh my God.
Exo.
Okay, good. Okay, eto ay exothermic, and then this is an endothermic reaction. Very good. So you always remember the energy dito ha, energy ng reactants will be greater than the energy of your product. So mababa ang energy ng products mo. While for endothermic,
why not?
Yes,
go ahead. Why doesn't the exothermic just proceed like this?
Because you don't have EA na.
Yun nga po.
Diba?
Maybe they are stable and then they'll just fall into a lower energy.
No. Usually, ibig sabihin yan, wala ka ng collision na naganap or wala kang interaction with your molecules. Diba?
Ano lang, decomposition.
Mm-hmm. Kasi diba, for a reaction to occur, you need to collide the molecules eh. Collision will always involve energy. Right? So, kaya meron ka dapat change of energy talaga. Kapag ganun kasi, Josh, ibig sabihin nun, pag nag-collide yung molecules nyo, diretso form ka agad ng products, right? Or possible, parang walang collision na naganap dun, Josh. And then, oh, voila, you just form your products. Can't be. So, parang you need to always have EA before you form your products. Okay? I have a question dito, Josh. Sino nga ulit yung nandito sa TokTok? Ayan, eto. Aside, the term is activated complex. What is the other term for activated complex?
Transition state.
Very good. Correct. Transition state. Wow. Yan. Transition state.
Hi, sir.
Ako, makakalimutan. Ay, good afternoon po, sir. Good afternoon po. Na po ba? Ayun, good afternoon po. So, ayun. Later po ako magla-lunch kasi galing din po ako sa isang klase. Anyway, okay lang po yan. Nag-breakfast naman po ako. So, ayun nga po. Kasi ang gusto ko ma-highlight dito, Josh, why is your transition state a transition state? By just looking sa graph.
Because it's the top of the hill that the ball never reaches, but it always reaches.
Why?
Mm-hmm. So in terms of in chemistry, if you have a top of the hill using an energy diagram, anong meaning nun? So may energy diagram ka, right? This is an energy diagram. Ah.
If it's technically stable kasi it's technically not unstable, but it lasts very extremely for an extremely short duration.
Very good. So actually, extremely unstable talaga siya yung transition state. Very, very unstable. Pero tama ka naman doon, nag-e-exist naman talaga siya. Di ba? Nag-send ako sa iyo ng journal that transition states can be observed, right? ano nga yun, mga femtoseconds lang sila nag-exist. And then eventually, they will be converted into products. So transition states are very unstable chemical species. So by the way, ang tawag dito ay energy diagrams because we have the potential energy. Or reaction progress diagram. Same lang yun, Josh. Okay, huwag kang malilito dun ha kapag may mga tanong na shown in the following problem will be the energy diagram for this reaction. O kaya, shown in the following problem will be the reaction progress diagram or reaction diagram for this reaction. Same lang yan sila because they will have energy as your y-axis. Lagi yan eh, si energy yung y-axis. Kapag energy diagram or reaction progress diagram. That's correct. So it means, Josh, unstable molecules will always have this high energy. So tingin mo may mga may unstable molecules ka pa aside from transition state. Can you recall? Kunwari, paano kapag stepwise yung reaction mo? Ibig sabihin, very good. Ang intermediate, actually, unlike your transition state, they're actually stable because they can be isolated. Eh. Yun nga lang, once you have an intermediate, your intermediate kasi can react quickly with another reactant and then can be converted to another product. So, pag ganun, Josh, kunwari, ah, pag may intermediate ka, what will be the shape of your energy diagram? Doon tayo mag-ano ha? Kunwari, no. Ganito siya, Josh. Yan. Diba you have your A plus B then going to C, right? Tapos si C, kunwari, magre-react ulit kay D to form E. So what is your overall reaction, Josh? What is your overall reaction muna?
A plus B right. Equals C.
A plus B?
Equals E. Wait.
Hindi pa. Tignan mo.
Equals E.
Ayun, very good. A plus B plus D. So ang na-cancel mo lang naman si C, eh, right? Then going to E. So, C is what? We call this what?
Intermediate.
Very good, intermediate. This is not a transition state, Josh. Di ba recall, ang transition state, may transition state ba to, yung first reaction mo?
Meron po, AB.
Okay, merong transition state yan. Excuse me, may transition state din ba yung second reaction mo?
Abo, CB.
Meron, correct din. May transition state yan. So si C, intermediate talaga siya. And C can be isolated. So isolable yan. Okay? So if that is the case, i-graph natin ha. Assuming this is an exothermic reaction. So what can you say about AB versus E, the energy? Which one will have higher energy value in terms of energy, Joshua? Again?
A, B, and B po.
AB versus E lang muna. Kasi yun lang naman. Ah, okay. Tama ka naman. A, B, D, they are all higher in energy than E. Kasi exothermic, right? Okay? Nasundan yun, Josh? Okay, good. So, lagyan mo ng label to ha. Energy. Minsan time to. Time or reaction progress. Same lang yan din, Josh. Kasi di ba as time, as your reaction progresses, you need to have time. Kaya kinetic graph din ito eh, yung mga energy diagrams. So let's say, eto si A plus B mo. Which are your initial products based from the mechanism? So eto yung tinatawag nating mechanism. Okay? So this is your overall reaction. Overall reaction. Okay? Ayan, thank you para sa pag-ano. What is your transition state? Sige, gawa ka ng parang hump.
Ilang
ikaw, ba? Ikaw mag-gumawa ng hump.
I will try and...
Ito kasi hindi natin pala ito na-cover eh. Nung chine-check ko yung ano, yung ano natin, discussion, sabi ko, ay parang di ko ito na-discuss kay Josh. Eh, na pansin ko na kailangan mo to. Okay? though hindi naman siya talaga dinidiscuss sa ordinary na chemical kinetics, you're not ordinary naman eh. So, let's include this one already. Very good. A plus B na yan. And then mag-hump ka so that you can form
ano, back into drafting.
Okay. That will be E lang. Okay, good. Your final product. So, AB ka muna ha. Si AB dapat mapaform niya si C. So, what can you say about sa C kaya? Ay, nako, hindi. Hindi ganyan ka agad.
Bro,
yes.
I will just make the line.
Ako na muna. O, asa na yung ano mo, green up mo. Para mamaya bibigyan kita ng may problem naman yata ako eh. Sige. Kaya yung ano natin, reaction natin. Okay na yan. Okay na ako dyan. So, I'll have a hump here, right? O, sino ito, Josh? Ayan, dyan muna ako.
E.
Sino ito ulit?
EA.
Very good. EA for the first reaction. Tama?
Abo.
First elementary reaction. So, this is EA1. Okay? And then, sa taas ni EA1, sino ito? Transition state 1. Okay? So, actually, you form here your AB. That's correct. Yung AB complex mo. Okay? And then, ang susunod is, you form what, Josh, muna? Once your AB react together, you'll form C, right?
Aba.
Okay. So, tapos si C magre-react kay D to form E. So, ang susunod nating question dito, si C kaya mas mataas sa energy kay E or mas mababa ang energy kay E?
Siguro po sa E.
Which one will have higher energy, E or C?
E po.
Higher energy, C or E? Again? Sige, isip. Okay, wait. Very good. Tama. Si C dapat. Tama ka doon. Si C dapat mas mataas yung energy kaysa kay E. Kasi nga, exothermic ito. So, ibig sabihin, dapat pag nag-react yung C mo, pababa na lalo yung energy. Okay? So, si C ay mas mataas yung energy niya. Let's say hanggang dito lang. Ayan. So, nandito ngayon si C. Then, tsaka magre-react si D. And then, you'll have another na hump. And this will be your EA2. That is your EA2. So you will see energy diagrams like this. This will be the energy diagram for the mechanism ng reactions na ito. Okay? Nakuha ito, Josh? Sige ha, bigyan kita ng theoretical problem ulit. Let's say, meron ka namang X plus Y forming, let's say, letter A. And then si letter A, nag-react kay letter B so that you can form Z. Pero the overall reaction, what's the overall reaction, Josh? Sige, give me the overall reaction.
Plus Y.
Okay, sulat mo. Okay, good. Very good.
What
other
equals somehow.
Okay. And then, this time, it's endothermic. Endothermic yung reaction, Joshua. And then, ito yung twist. Lalagyan kita ng twist. Balik tayo dito, ha? Para maisip mo siya. Ngayon, I have a question, Josh. Which one is a faster reaction? AB going to C or CD going to E with this kind of diagram. AB going to C, CD going to E. Again?
CD going to E.
Okay. Why? What is the reason?
Maliit gap.
Very good. Ay, ano maliit yung gap? Hindi. Hindi yan yung sagot. Which one is a faster reaction? Pero tama naman kasi nga, T-reaction eh. Ah, hindi ko lang nagawa to relative ha? Or parang commensurate with the ano. Pero sumakto lang, tumama din siya. Sino talaga titignan mo to have a fast reaction? Ah, balik ka sa catalyst. What are catalysts again? Sige, explain.
They cause the reaction to... they cause the reaction to move faster, but sometimes are consumed, but not always. But will be
okay.
At the end.
Okay, correct. And how they will make your reactions faster, Ulit? Discuss natin yan.
They will aid the collision by making a
microenvironments. Correct? So they will provide correct environment so that your reaction can take so that your reaction will be faster. Parang mas proper yung orientation, mas higher yung collision. But in terms of energy, ano yung ginagawa ni catalyst?
Makes the EA smaller.
Very good. It makes your EA smaller. Ngayon, looking sa diagram, magkakaroon ka ngayon ng idea. So which will be the faster reaction? A B going to C or C plus D going to E? Your answer is correct, C plus D going to E. Because if you will notice here, EA2 greater than or less than EA1?
Less than. Well, okay, actually po, I was thinking, even if the EA is smaller, kumaga po yung delta G is more negative. It cannot see how fast the reaction will proceed.
Yes, correct. Tama yon. Hindi mo kaya masasabi. Pero ang EA kasi, it's a measure of the yung delta G. Ito kasi yun ni pero delta H nga ang kuha natin dito eh. Spontaneity yun eh. Ayan. This will be the overall delta H, right? Kasi ito yun eh, products and reactants dapat eh. And this is negative, right? So this is exothermic. So this one dictates your energy change. Okay? But the spontaneity, makukuha mo ba yung spontaneity dito? We cannot clearly calculate that as long as we are not having the delta G value. But in a sense, we can have an idea, okay, this is kind of spontaneous because this is an exothermic reaction. And if you will notice, yung mga EA involved ay pababa naman siya. So parang kind of meron kang idea, though not conclusive, na ito ay spontaneous. So remember ha, delta G is for spontaneity. The next question will be, how fast your reaction will be? So even though you're given with the delta H, ayan, may delta H ka, you cannot easily calculate or you cannot easily parang conclude that this is a fast reaction unless otherwise you look for their EAs. Clue mo ngayon din yung EA mo. Clue mo lang yung EA ha. Diba yung catalyst kasi, usually they will have lower EA. Yun yung laging basis namin eh. Pag mas mababa ang EA, mas mabilis talaga ang reaction. Because you will require only your molecules with smaller energy for them to react together. So,
pero sir, yung bang EA, you need less energy to activate the reaction, di ba po? So, pero,
yes, correct.
Is it a reflective of the total na parang yung spontaneity na ano po, na mas lahat, kung idadisek yung 100% na reaction, every 1% requires less.
Yes, correct, sir. Kaya nga sabi ko po, parang
mas konti.
Idea lang siya. Sige po.
Parang kunyari, kumbaga, there are 100 parts there that will react. Each percent, bali mas konti ang activation niya na energy na kaya.
Yes, correct. Oo, parang ang mangyayari, sir, kapag mababa ang EA, actually, more parts will react faster. Kasi mababa lang po yung EA mo eh. So, a larger portion of your reactants will be converted into products already. So ngayon, parang in a sense, may ano ka, may idea ka for spontaneity without calculating the delta G. You'll have an idea na usually faster reaction will have a more spontaneous reaction. Yun po yung idea natin. Pero sabi ko nga, hindi kasi siya conclusive kasi minsan may mga mabibilis na reaction kapag nag-start na siya. Pero pag yung delta G mo ay positive, ibig sabihin, hindi naman pala siya spontaneous to begin with. Parang na-imagine nyo, sir, kunwari po, parang nag-initiate ka nung reaction, mabilis siya, pero mabilis din siya. Yes, sir. Parang ganun. Mm-mm. Kasi nga, to begin with, non-spontaneous pa na yung reaction. Ganun din dun sa kabaligtaran or sa vice versa. You have an exothermic reaction, but the reaction is actually slow. Okay? So, ibig sabihin nun, malaking EA yun. So, pwede pong isang reason yun. Malaki masyado yung EA.
If you're going to think of it, parang yung ano, combustion of yung material, kung it is of a flammable material, ibig sabihin, kunyari, madali siya ignite, lower activation energy, di ba po?
Yes. And then, mabilis din, ano rin po siya, exothermic, right? So, ayun, ang kaya ang ano po, ang fire talaga and ang flame ay spontaneous na, mabilis pa, nag-combine. Kasi mababa combine po yung EA.
Pero we must put in, take into consideration there will be some materials na some compounds na hindi ganun, no?
Yes, yun po yung mga fire retardants. Fire retardants, baliktad. Or may ano siya. Ang nangyari po, spontaneous siya. Yung flaming nga po, spontaneous ha. Pero mabagal po siya. Ang taas ng EA ng mga fire retardants eh. Masasunog at masasunog po ang fire retardants. Or they will undergo combustion. But they will undergo combustion in a lesser time. Or a lesser time. Longer time. Kasi po, masyadong mataas naman yung EA. Yung kinetics naman po yung usapan doon. Ayun, magandang ano po yun ha. Maganda siyang ano, example. Yung mga fire versus fire retardants. Yung mga flammable materials.
Pero kunyari, low EA. Pero once activated, will proceed slowly. Medyo mahirap lang po yun, no? Ano kaya yung mga factors?
Nag-iisip nga po ako ng ano eh. Nag-iisip nga ako ng reaction na ganun eh.
May ganun po eh. Yung madaling i-burn pero mabagal ma-consume. Plastic? May ganun na plastic.
Yung mga fire retardants. Pwede rin kasi fire retardants ganyan eh. Mababa ang... mababa po ang EA pero...
the combustion will proceed slowly. Matagal, di ba po?
Mataas po yung EA noon pag ganun. Pero exothermic siya. Kasi dalawang side po tayo tinitingnan natin eh. May thermoside ka na, tapos may kinetics. So parang ang possible combination po ay, let's say, exothermic. Di ba parang ang isip kasi natin lagi, exothermic is spontaneous siya, right? Parang ganun po. Kasi isang factor yan eh. Spontaneous. Parang ang conclusion natin, this one will be a fast reaction. Which is, ito po yung nangyayari sa fire. Combustion. Exothermic, fast reaction. So, ganyan po siya. Ang iniisip naman natin, tunari po, pag fire retardant naman, exothermic pa rin po siya and it's still spontaneous. Yun nga lang, slow reaction po siya.
Because of higher EA.
Yes, sir. Kasi ito, mataas ang EA ng mga fire retardants.
It's impossible. So,
pero meron po ba siyang exothermic? Low EA, pero slow
baka
ang
impossible
ano.
Impossible yung combination.
Slow ang...
Oo, iniisip ko nga. Tama din po si Joshua, sir. Medyo nag-agree ako sa kanya. I'm not really familiar with this. Wala pa po ako nakikitang combination na mababa ang EA, tapos slow exothermic, ang pero slow siya. Kasi usually po, ang interpretation, if you have a high EA, automatic, the reaction will be slow. If you have a smaller EA, the reaction will be fast.
Okay.
Ganun po yung ano niya. Ganun po yung pinakamabilis na explanation. Kung may magde-deviate man doon, most probably may nangyayari doon sa mechanism ng reaction na that will make your reaction slow ang EA niya, small ang EA, pero mabilis na. Tama po ba ako? Small or...
Slow EA, small... pero slow... smaller EA, but small EA, but slow.
Ah, oo. Medyo ano nga po yun. Very, very rare na combination. Kasi ang lagi po nating observation is usually reactions which will be occurring in a very fast manner. Small na yung EA nila. Pero pag slow reaction siya, large EA, regardless kung exo or endothermic po siya.
Apo.
Kasi ibang issue siya eh. Kaya si thermo and kinetics po, you need to combine them so that you can have an overall idea dun sa reaction. So, parang complementary talaga sila. Ayan. So, sa mga catalysis Joshua, may mga ganito kasi na nag-wrap para kunwari nag-advanced reading ka or mag-read ka ng mga journals, pag nagpakita sila ng energy diagram, you'll not be surprised na ay bakit multiple ito, kasi 'di ba ang tinuturo ko lang lagi ay yung single, right? The single one. Yung ganito, right? Kasi ito ay overall na. So minsan pagpapakita yung mechanism, you'll see na okay, ito automatic intermediate ito.
Meron okay? meron ba pong parang kasi ito pa rin po parang dalawang hump na kita ko po eh. Mhm. Pag
you want multiple humps? Pwede 'yun.
Pwede po nga multiple humps, pero meron ba pong ganito na mid hump ni parang metastable state?
Oh, yes. Oh. Ayan, ito nga parang ganito 'yan eh. Hindi ko lang siya inayos, pero parang ganyan siya, Josh. Ayan. Ito yun, di ba? Kamukha niya to. At asan dito yung intermediate. And then that is your parang sinasabi mong metastable state. That metastable state actually contains your intermediate.
Does that mean po it can be both exothermic and endothermic at the same time?
Yes. May possible na combination. Try nga natin gumawa ng ganun. Asan yung ano ko? Sige, try natin. Ito. Yeah. Ito, anong reaction to? Endo to, right? Pero yung susunod, exo. Ayan, combination to. Pero tignan mo, with endothermic siya, with respect to A, converted into B. Endothermic yan. Pero yung B, with respect to conversion of B to C, exothermic. And then overall, kasi overall to eh, this will be exo. Possible yun, yung sinasabi mo. Pwede rin mag-combine ka ng endo. Yeah, this is endo, right? Then another endo. Pwede rin to. May mga ganyan na combination.
Kaya po, nandito po yung nangyari po dito sa C. Endo pa rin po overall.
Yes. Possible din yan. Ito yan yung gusto mo eh. Ganyan. Tapos ganito. Right?
Abo.
Yan. Correct. Pwede rin din. May mga ganyan na reaction. Mas mataas pa rin yung energy ng products kumpara dun sa reactants. Endothermic siya. Pero we cannot easily say na this is a fast or a slow reaction. Unless you'll see the EA. And then, laging relative kasi siya, Josh, eh. Pag fast or slow, dapat lagi kang may pagkukumparahan. Ano ba siya? Compared sa ganitong reaction, compared sa other reaction, so that you can have a relative na relative sense ng reaction rate. Okay? So, we can just predict na ang pwede mong ma-compare dito, yung two reactions involved. Ilang reactions to, Josh? Di ba two reactions to, let's say A converted into B, then converted into C. So you have AB here, then BC here. So what can you conclude about the about this energy diagram, Josh? Which one will be faster, AB, BC?
BC.
Very good. This is fast and this will be slow. What is your basis? Tama yan, tama. Marunong ka na mag-interpret. What is your basis? Again?
EA.
EA. Which one will have higher EA? The first or the second reaction?
First reaction ba?
Okay. Pakita mo nga yung EA ng ano. Ibigay mo sa akin yung graph ng EA or lagayan mo lang ng range. EA for ano. Gawin mo na lang magkaibang color. Eh, sige, black yan for AB. Okay. And then how about for BC? Ayun, correct. So we can clearly see here that the EA for BC will be smaller. So fast reaction siya. And then si AB naman ay mataas yung EA, so slower reaction siya. So I think we can now proceed with we can go back dun sa ating ano ha slide. Yan mas ano mas better yung discussion natin ngayon about this. Ngayon, balik tayo dito ha. We're good with this one. Ito. So, the ones that we mentioned a while ago, that is actually reaction mechanism. In a real sense kasi, or in the real world, Joshua, once you have an overall reaction, some of your reactions will not occur directly. Stepwise siya. Okay? Yung parang ginawa natin kanina, yung AB converted muna to C, and then C, you form the E products, yun yung overall reaction mo. So, this overall reaction are actually made from elementary steps. So, elementary steps yung tinatawag nating per reaction. Okay? So, ngayon, these elementary steps will have their own transition state. They will have their own rates as well. So, ibig sabihin nito, Josh, kunwari, ito yung first reaction mo. Anong tawag natin sa rate constant nito? We call this one K1. Okay, K1. Kasi first reaction mo ito eh. Para hindi ka malito ah. So yung number 2 mo, this will be K2. K1, K2. They will have their own reaction. So ngayon, what can you say about the rate constant nung overall reaction? It must be the combination of K1 and K2. So ngayon, hindi ko muna to ituturo ah kasi sa FICEM muna to maano sa advance ano to, advance na kinetics mo siya malalaman. Ngayon, ang either mga combination, ano mga possible combinations dito, Josh? K1 over K2 or pwede rin itong K1 K2. Multiplication. Or pwede rin namang K2 over K1. Those are the possible combinations so that this can give you the rate constant. Okay? The overall rate constant. So, ayan. Okay na yan. Intermediate. Ang susunod ngayon dito will be the rate determining step. So, based from these elementary steps, which reaction will be your rate determining step? Sino yung rate determining step mo dyan? Step 1 or step 2?
Step 1.
Why?
I have no idea.
Okay. So, balikan natin yung meaning ng rate determining step. Ha? So, last time, na-define ko siya, yung rate determining step, this is the slowest step in the sequence of steps leading to product formation. So this rate determining step dictates your reaction rate kasi siya yung pinakamabagal na step eh, right? Dictates your reaction rate. So therefore, between 1 and 2, which is your rate determining step? Step 1 or step 2? Ayan, nakalagay na siya dyan eh. Okay. So, step 2 ang magiging rate determining step mo. Sir, paano ko po nalalaman kung fast or slow? Experimental siya. Kaya sabi ko sa'yo, ang kinetics talagang experiment siya. So, usually, ganito siya, Joshua, nakalagay na dyan yung term na fast and slow sa mga problems. Unless otherwise, pahulain ka ng mga ano, ng mga gumawa ng tanong kung sino yung fast and slow. You will go back to their stability.
When back when they have to go to the lab.
So, aanihin mo ha, you need to go back to the stability para magkakaroon ka ng idea kung sino yung magiging fast at sino yung magiging slow. Another idea mo dyan, Josh, eto, yung mga arrows. Eto, ayan. Ano nga ulit pag reversible? Ay, sorry, pag double-headed arrow, reversible, right? So, and then eto, irreversible. So, between the two, what do you think will be faster reaction? Reversible or irreversible reaction?
Irreversible.
Of course, this one will be a faster reaction. Okay? Kasi pag na-convert mo na yung product mo, yun na yun. As isa siya. Pag reversible kasi, slower siya because pag na-convert mo yung product, na-convert mo yung reactant mo into products, your products might react again and then you go back to being reactant. So it will take more time for you to convert fully your reactants into products. Kaya siya nagiging slower.
It's possible to convert all of the reactants into products.
Because correct, pag reversible.
Pag-reversible. Balikan, no? Nagbabalik. Parang sa,
yes, sir.
Parang ping-pong reaction.
Nasabi ko nga po yung ping-pong ball.
Unless otherwise, may ano ka, Josh, ha? May ano dito, catch. Unless otherwise, may catch. Iko-couple mo yung reversible reaction with an irreversible one.
Ah, yes.
Para mapipilitan ka ngayon na pag nabubuo mo ngayon si ano, si, let's say, nabuo mo si, bigyan kita ng idea. Kasi ito yung susunod mong topic eh, equilibrium. Si equilibrium kasi, Josh, yun yung reversible. Balikan siya. So, kunwari ganito, Josh, ha? A plus B.
When there's an entire branch of kinetics that's even bigger than kinetics, only
for... Uy, correct. This, oh, no. Ito, etong arrow na yan, ay, Diyos ko, makikita mo siya ng napakatagal kasi malaking big, ano siya, big topic siya sa chem din, tong reversible reactions. Kasi this will lead to equilibrium eh. Eh, yun yung sinasabi ni ng dad mo. It's like a ping-pong. Napabalik-balik siya. Kasi equilibrium, right? So you form the products and the products will be forming again into reactants. But, let's say, ito si Sia. But if you will couple that reaction with this, ayun, then to form E, what will happen to your first reaction? It so will be forced.
No more time for the C to convert back into AB. Or in case that the C indeed turns back into AB and then turns back into C, there's a higher chance that it will just be converted to E. Kumbaga nga po, ganito, instead of po maraming ping-pong balls gumagano'n, may parang isa pong trash bin sa likod. Para after some time,
doon po siya nasushoot
eventually.
Mm-mm. Yeah, so si C dito, CC, instead of that's a good conclusion to siya. Instead of C being converted back into your products, CC ngayon napopersa siya, it will be forced to react with your D to form your final products kasi coupled na sila ngayon, right? So, if that is the case, Josh, babalik ako sa 1. What will be the shift for your reaction? Shift to the right or shift to the left?
Right.
Very good. Or shift to the formation of your products. Sinisimulan ko na yung ano ha, shift to the right. Ganyan yung mga tanungan dyan sa equilibrium. Kasi pag equilibrium, di ba once you have an equilibrium na reaction and then you introduce a stress. Stress ito eh, yung number 2 ha. Para siyang stress sa mga chemical reactions. So imaginein mo dyan siya, hindi lang tayo ang may stress, hindi lang tao or biological organisms or living organisms, even chemical systems, we have this term called stress. Okay? Kasi parang imaginein mo, nung una, freely existing lang sila, itong equilibrium reaction mo na ito. Pero you added a stress. So, paano mo i-add yung stress? Ha? Ito, you added D to the mixture. So, D will react with this one. So, you'll be forced, or the equilibrium will be forced to shift to the right so that you can compensate for the letter C na nakukonsume ni letter D. Okay? So, anyway, matututunan mo yan sa equilibrium mo. But for this one, if that is the case, ito yung slow reaction mo and this will be your, anong tawag natin dito? Pag slow reaction?
The rate determining.
Very good. this will be your rate determining step. Since this is the slower reaction, this will dictate the rate of your reaction. Or the overall reaction, yung overall reaction will depend sa rate ng first elementary step mo. Okay, so dyan siya magaan. So, ang susunod kong ano dito, let's go back to our slide ha. Ayan. Ang susunod kong question, kasi I'm exposing you to the possible questions in reaction mechanisms as early as now. Can you propose a transition state for one? Reaction one muna. Di ba sabi ko sa'yo, nasabi mo na rin. Di ba may transition state ka for reaction one? You also have transition state for reaction two.
Oh no.
Ako mag-propose ha. Hindi, sige. Hati tayo. I'll propose transition state for one. Let's go to our whiteboard concentration camp.
Kumbaga po, that just means you can have isomers that are totally not related to each other.
Yeah, yung pwede naman. The best ano siya ha, logical yung na propose.
Kumbaga Benji may isomer po siya yung prismin. It should be kumbaga totally different kumbaga. Meron po pong ganun yung N2O4 is total, it there's no relation with the other N2O4.
N2O4 na isomer.
Aba, N2O4 na N2O4 formed from N2O2 and O2 should be
okay. You should be clear with the reaction itself. So dapat clear ka muna kung ano yung ano mo. Ito yung elementary step 1 mo muna. Ayan, binabagay ko lang yung ano ha. You should be clear with the reactants involved. Benzene ba yun or yung isomer niya yung ginamit mo. Para at least kapag nagpropose ka ng transition state or reaction mechanism, you'll always have an idea na okay, ito ay yung isomeric form niya or the other isomeric form 2NO2. And then what's our overall reaction? So this will be 2NO gas plus O2 gas going to 2NO2 gas. Okay, so you have your own transition state here. Usually, yung transition state Joshua, nilalagyan natin siya ng asterisk. Asterisk denotes it's a highly energetic chemical species. Sa mga books and references, even sa journals, pag naka-asterisk Joshua, highly energetic siya na species. So, as I'll propose for transition state 1. So, ano nga ulit yung NO natin? Ayan, balik tayo. Ako ulit ha. Structure, proposal. So, it's NO. N is group number. Anong group number?
It's just, I remember NO is a free radical. It's just a double bond NO and then there's an electron on top of N. Probably.
Correct. O, sige, pero babalikan natin kasi ang tagal natin dito last time eh. Para systematic tayo. Anong group number ni NO? Ay, ni nitrogen? Group number 5. Then 1. Then O. 6. Then 1. So, we need to see how many electrons, Josh?
Electron.
11.
Math 11.
11 valence.
I'm so stupid. I forgot na 5 plus 6 is not equal to 13.
Okay. So this will only use 2. So may 9 valence ka. Mabilisan ito ha. 9 valence na electron. So I'll distribute this sa dalawa. So of course, I know oxygen will get 6, right? So may ilang pang may iwan kay nitrogen? Tatlo na lang, right? Correct?
Tabo.
But this is not stable yet. Sir, bakit hindi po ito stable? Because this one will have a negative 1 na formal charge. And then, what's the formal charge for nitrogen?
One.
Balik tayo. Let's see kung 1 ba siya. Formal charge, what is the formula? Group number?
5.
Okay, group minus number minus the number of
one
bonds?
1 minus unpaired.
Okay.
Minus unpaired electron.
Like, okay, or non-bonding electrons. Yun yung term natin. Non-bonding electrons. How many non-bonding, Josh?
3.
Count as is. Correct. 3. Hindi lone pairs to, Josh. Ha? Last time kasi ginawa mo, lone pairs yung pinilang mo. Eh. So this will be what will be the answer? Last one, right?
So, ah, it's correct.
Good. So this is not a stable molecule because you have both formal charges for the atoms involved. So let's form double bonds this time. So maglalagay ako ng double bonds. So you'll now have ganito. Double bond O, then O. Oh, of course, we know, pag double bond na yung O, ano na yung charge niya, Josh? Zero na yan. Kasi di ba, oxygen with a double bond character, automatic, zero ang formal charge. Ngayon, yung formal charge ni nitrogen ang need natin i-calculate dito. So this is 5 pa rin, pero minus 2, minus 3, therefore zero. So both of them are zero. So this is the most stable form. The NO, that's correct. It's a radical. So NO is a radical. Okay. So ang susunod mong ano dito, ano yung nabubuo? Si N2O2, right? So let's propose N2O2 naman. So paano pag N2O2, Josh? Magkakaroon na ako ng idea. Ang gagawin ko lang kay N2O2, Josh, ay ganito. N, tapos double bond na to, right? Ayan. And then ito. Tapos, ayan. And then ito. Correct? Tapos, let's see kung meron pa ba itong check na lang natin. Ilan yung ano dapat valence electron na makikita ko, Josh? For N2O2.
There should be...
Parang ito times 2 mo lang yung 11.
Ah,
right? Oo nga, di ba? Ikaw ha. Oh, short ka tayo, syempre. N2O2 is ano eh. NO times 2 lang. So, 22 valence electrons, right? So, ilan na yung nakikita natin? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18. So, if that is the case, may double bond ka ngayon. May lone pair ka ngayon dito. So, this is a stable molecule already. So, eto ngayon yan.
Form another bond.
Hmm?
Why don't they form another bond?
Ay, stable na to eh. Zero na to. Zero na to. Zero na to. Zero na to. Ito yung susunod kong tanong. Tingin ka sa nitrogen, what is the shape? Nako, ayan na. Supposed to be, what is the shape?
Oh, it's a bent. It looks like
correct, water siya. Very good. Bent ito. What is the electron domain? Molecular shape. Anong electron domain mo? So, pag electron domain, you include the lone pair.
3 po.
Again?
3.
3. So, correct. So, what is the electron domain?
Trigonal.
Very good.
Pyramidal. So,
trigonal planar.
Abo, o kaya ganyan.
Okay. Kasi tatlo lang eh. Okay, yun. So,
very good. Kala ko po, pag ganun yung nitrogen.
Eh, hindi. Ano yan? Kapag ano siya, naka-three bonds. Eh, naka-three bonds ba ito? I mean, naka-three domains? I mean, nitrogen will have a tetrahedral configuration if we'll have four domains. Pero if you will see here, three domains lang siya. Ayan, no, di ba parang counted as one to? One domain, another domain, then another domain. So if you will see here, parang ganito siya. So ito yung lone pair mo, right? Tapos ito yung single bond, tapos ito yung double bond. Correct? Ngayon, very good. Makakapag-propose ka ng dalawang possible scenario. Ano yung possible scenario mo, Josh? Yung drawing mo kanina. Sige, tapos gagawin ko siyang molecule. Either, yung kanina, yung inano mo, kahit i-linear mo na lang yung line formula. Then ako na magko-convert into ano? Into one. Okay, pwede yan. Or you can also have what? So, eto yan ha. Okay, good. So, N, so we'll have this one. Tapos double bond O. That's correct. Double bond O. And then this one, that's correct. N. Ito. O. Tapos N. Tapos O. In reality, Josh, which one is more more stable? Tingin mo. The cis or the trans? Ito yung tinatawag nating cis or trans. Pag cis, same side. So, if you will see here, naka-same side si O.
Ito ba yung mas stable ng trans? Kasi dito po may ganyan.
Very good. Magkakaroon ka ng anong tawag sa ganyan? Ano yung ganyan na yan? Uy, naturo ko yan. Sa
repelling forces.
Strain ang tawag dyan. Oh, correct. Repelling forces yon. Anong strain yan? Create ba siya ng angle? Created ba siya ng angle? Yes or no muna?
No po.
Correct, kasi hindi naman naka-ring. Remember, Josh, ha? Pag angle strain, naka-involve yung ring. So ano to? Mga magkakapit-bahay na substituents, right? They're like repelling each other because they're quite near. Pero magkahiwalay naman sila ng bond. Anong tawag sa strain na yon? Angle strain and?
Molecular strain.
Naalala siya? Hindi. Letter S.
Strain.
Another guess.
SARS-CoV-2 COVID-2 strain.
Ayan. Oh. Ilan ba siya? Six strain. Letters. Naging wordle siya, no? Kaya parang nanghula ka ng ano, word. Ay, nako, nakalimutan na.
Subtle strain.
Sige, para mabilis tayo, ha? Letter C ang dulo.
What? That is C.
Oh, letter I. Parang stoichiometry ba to?
Ano ito?
Oh, letter E. Oh, ayan na. Oh. Anong strain yan? Ste?
What? Strain?
Ste? Steric strain.
Steric, ano? Yung steric. Acid? Parang ganun.
Hindi, iba pa yun. Stearic acid. Iba yun. Magkaiba yung spelling nila eh. Ang stearic acid mo ay ganito. Right? Ang steric strain ay ganito. Magkaiba siya. Ayan. Okay? So, correct. Tama yan. Pero if that is the case, eto ngayon yung susunod kong tanong, Josh. With that in mind, so, punta ako dito ha, kasi nagpropose tayo mechanism eh. With that in mind, ano ang gusto kong mabuo, Josh? N2O2, right? And then coming from 2NO. So, pag meron akong 2NO approaching each other, Josh, ano dapat yung itsura? Di ba parang ganito yon?
Meron pa ba N-O-O-N para ano?
Para hindi. Sino dapat ang katapat na magbubungguan? Kunwari, magbubungguan sila. They will collide. Sino katapat dapat ni N? Very good. Tama. Tama yun. Sige. I'll place it here. Yan. Okay? And then O. Sir, bakit po? Para ito, tingnan mo to ha. Ito, ayan. Pag binigay nila yan, nag-share sila, anong mabubuo dito, Josh?
Ito band.
Very good. This is a bond already. Tapos, sino yung mabubuo?
N2O2.
Ayan. At here. Ano yung configuration? Naka-ano pa siya? Naka-cis pa siya, no?
Theory, the configuration. If they collide like this, will they
no. Or
they're slightly...
they will not react.
If they are slightly at an angle... Mm. Will physics make this go together?
Yeah, possible. Pwede naman. I'm not limiting naman the ano, orientation eh. But this will be the most plausible orientation. Ito yung most plausible orientation.
Pakita pa yung most plausible orientation.
Bakit? They're going parallel ways. So if that is the case, okay ha. Pag transition state, Josh, yan, mga rules sa transition state. Ipapakita mo yung... So, eto. Yan, igaganyan mo siya. It means either bond broken or bond form.
Why don't they make bond broken like this and then bond form like this?
Hindi, transition state ito eh. Transition state siya. So, regardless kung nababond broken ba siya or bond form, parang... Di ba pag bond, pag transition state, Josh, you cannot identify which bond will be broken, which bond will be formed. Kasi nasa gitna siya eh. Right? Nasa gitna siya. So, ngayon, may bond broken pa for NO, Josh? Question. Okay. Pero may bond na mabubuo. So, this will be the transition state. Ito na ha. Idodrawing ko na yung transition state, Josh. 10, 10, 10, 10. And then, lone pair. Tapos, ito. Ayan. Double bond O. And then, pwede mong lagyan ng ganito. Ayan. Kasi transition state. And then, ganito. So, ang meaning nito, Josh, highly energetic. Ayan. That is your transition state. Yeah, so we actually produce or we actually propose the first transition state for this for this reaction. Ayan, na-propose na natin 'to. Check na tayo dito, Josh. Ayan. So ngayon, gawan mo ko ng transition state for number 2.
Okay. Impossible.
So N2O2. Kaya yan. Meron ka na ba nito? May structure ka na nito, Josh? Meron na. Na-drawing na natin. Ito yan, no? May structure ka na nito, Josh. NO2 muna. Wala pa. So, gawan mo muna ng structure si NO2.
I already memorized the structures.
Okay, go ahead. Propose first a structure for NO2.
Found out po the nitrogen oxide are evil. Oh, wait, what am I doing? Propose a structure. I already memorized them. Ha, ha.
Yeah. Ah, yung naka-resonance yata yung sa'yo. Oh, give me one resonance structure lang.
Bro, imagine.
Okay. Good. Okay, i-ano lang natin ha, calculate natin ha. What is the formal charge for this one, Josh? Sa zero mo? Oxygen, zero tuloy. Oxygen with double bond. What is the formal charge?
Nothing. No.
Okay, zero. How about this one? Oxygen with single bond.
Bakit may lone pair dito? Ay, ba may lone electron?
We'll see.
Full na dapat push eh.
Sige, check natin. What is your ano dito? Oxygen. Charge. Negative? One, right? Okay. How about for this one? Formal charge in nitrogen. This is group number 5. Minus how many bonds? 3. And then, how many ano? Ano nga ito? How many na electron? 1. So, plus 1. Correct. So, overall, anong charge nito? Zero.
Meron ba po na?
So, kahit wala na to ha? Kahit wala na yan.
Meron pa pong ganyan?
Ano yan? N2O? NO3?
Abok na ganyan.
Alam hindi. Yung... Mag-nitrate ka na.
Hindi. Ayoko po. Gusto ko po may ano eh. Para I can form N2O6.
Anyway, ayan, Josh, habang may call kasi ako, hindi ko alam kung ano tong call na to. Oh, propose now the, ano, ano nga ito? Transition state for the second reaction. Ito yung second reaction mo. N2O2 reacting with O2 to form NO2. Sige, wait lang ha. Ay, ayan, nawala na siya. Nawala na yung call. Ayaan mo na siya. Feeling ko PLDT yan. Eh. Kasi nireklamo ko po yung PLDT namin. Kasi ano siya eh, nag-intermittent eh. So, sabi ko po masyado po siyang malaking abala sa amin kapag intermittent po. So, ayun. At least kahit pa paano lagi, mabilis yung
lagi
action.
Lagi po kami nagpapadala ng message na kasi pag hindi ka nagpadala, anong tawag kasi?
Pabayaan lang nila yan.
Pabagal.
Ano po ba kayo din, sir? PLDT?
Hindi po, Converge.
Ah, Converge naman po. Naku, may issues din po. Lagi pa naman ang Converge.
Pero dito sa Tarlac kasi mas better than PLDT.
Ah, I see. So, minsan,
kunyari nasira.
Tama po yan.
Ang tagal i-repair.
Mm-mm. Ano po yan eh. Iaano mo talaga din sa lugar eh. Kung ano yung ano niya eh.
Ano yung mas
kung ano po yung maganda. Mm-mm. Basta continue lang, Josh, ha. Paano ko ba ito? Yeah, ano. Ayan. Okay.
It's like, I think I can change this. Ah!
Mm.
It messed it up. Oh no.
Hindi, ang gawin mo, okay, sige. Tama naman.
Oh, I'm genius.
Parang ito ha, ang strategy mo, Josh, I'll give you an idea. Ang strategy mo dyan, Josh, is dapat
stable. Ah!
Ayun, there. Dapat ilang ano N2 oy mag-start ka dito oh, you start with this one, this is your given eh, tapos ito yung another na O2 mo, dapat pag pinagtabi mo sila ito yung makukuha mo, right? It's N2O2.
I will get N2O4 that it will be dissociate into NO.
Yes, correct. N2O2 muna, react that with O2 so that it can have two NO2s.
I'm gonna make a flimsy okay. Bond between NO2 so it will dissociate into two NO2. Yeah, flimsy bond. It looks like N2O. Oh, it is N2O4. How does this form though?
N2O4 yan. Mm. Ibang issue yan. Ibang reaction yan. Pero we don't have N2O4 in our reaction. Oh.
So, yung issue mo kasi, ito po yung may, so there's a, ito po yung trans na NO2. O2 comes flying from here. It goes down. And then, it breaks here po.
Medyo mahirap siya.
Na ganun.
Hindi siya ideal na orientation. Oh, think of. Sige.
It could hindi work. Yan, for, oh. It could work for both cis and trans.
You try cis this time. Ay, nangyari. You try trans. Ayan, cis. You try cis this time. Oh. And then react that with O2. Oh, asan yung O2 mo? Wag mo munang buuin yung product. Where's your O2?
The O2 comes
ayan. Here. Where will your... Okay, oh, ayan. Oh, sige. If that is the case, signa mo. Ano mangyayari? Ayan, sige. React. And then? Uh-huh. And then puputulin mo ngayon yung nasa kabila, right? Mapuputol okay. Din to, right? For the NN and OO, they will be broken, right? Ito, oh. This bond can be broken. Ayan. You now have this product. 2N2O.
Then it must work for trans din.
Ah, hindi. Sige, isis mo muna para mas magkaroon ka ng idea. You red draw dito sa area na to. Ayan. Tapos proper orientation mo na. Make it vertical para mas makita mo. O, pwede rin naman yan. Okay, good. Broken. So, yung form mo, asaan? Okay? How many oxygen bonds will be broken? Dapat makikita mo rin yun. Okay, good. Ayan. May mga lone pair bang involved?
Wala po.
Okay, good. Okay, so this is your transition state. Proposed transition state. Sige, continue. Ito, how about this O?
They have no more lone pairs. I remove them.
Sige, let's see.
Venus rotation.
Sige, yung clean mo na, the clean transition state with proper with proper label. Continue mo lang yung dun sa other right side. Yeah, sige. Okay. That bond will be broken, right? Oops. Ah, okay, after na ng reaction ito. Okay, good. Tama naman. Sige, burahin ko lang to ha para at least dyan na lang tayo mag-aano dito sa kanan. Ay, sa kaliwa, rather. Yeah, this one.
Literally.
Okay na to. Ito, yung sabi ko, lalagyan mo lang siya ng ganito and then ganyan. O, ayan. O, you propose a trans. Diba? Mahirap siya. Kasi it's not properly oriented. Where will you place their oxygen?
Ito nga po yung theory from above.
O kaya, from above pero parallel with your end. Right? Pwede naman eh, no?
This is the concept of 3D.
Pero, kung trans siya, let's say ha, kasi nandito, ang mahirap dyan, Josh, andito yung lone pair mo, andito rin yung lone pair mo. Kasi trigonal planar ito eh. Right? So, dapat, ito yung mabroken mo. So, kung ito yung need mong mabroken, yeah, pwede. Nasa taas nga siya, Josh. Pero dapat naka-parallel, right? Parang dapat naka-ganun. What I mean, parallel to your NN, not parallel to the plane. Kasi pag ginawa mo, parang ganito yung NN mo, eh, right? Ginawa mo, naka-ganito yung double bond O mo. So the interaction will be less. Marerepel pa nga eh. Yan! Marerepel pa nga ng lone pair eh. Ayun, may lone pair ka dito. Then another large lone pair here. So, yeah. Kasi itong double bond na, itong single bond na to, pwede na siyang mabroken talaga. And excuse me. Pwede na talaga siyang mabroken. That's correct. Ah, possible, no? Parang orientation-wise, you can also proceed with trans. Yun nga lang, dapat naka-3D ka. Nasa top siya talaga nung ano.
Chemists, after discovering they can, that molecules can, molecules can react in three dimensions.
Yeah. Pero, kasi, by the way, Josh, ha, may energy din kasing involved if we will convert, di ba, ito yung mas stable, the trans, N2O2, right? May energy ding involved if we want to convert that into cis N2O2. Yan, usually may trans N2O2, cis N2O2. May energy na involving dyan. Okay? Yeah, I think you're very good with this reaction mechanism. Mas natin na siya, no? Mas na-explore na natin siya and mas na-explain natin siya. I'll give you a very concrete example why reaction mechanisms will be important, Joshua. Tingnan mo to. Ay, sorry. Okay. Page 6 na pala ito. Page 5. Lumaktan pala tayo. So, yan. page 6. Page 7 tayo. I'll give you an example here, Joshua.
Ruined.
Ito. CH3. Then let's say CH. And then bromine. Tapos let's say here, CH3. And then let's say you have here OH. Of course, this is negative. Think of this will came from NaOH. Okay? So, ganyan siya. Ito yung source mo. NaOH. Diba, nadidissolve naman ito sa water, right? Yung NaOH. Soluble. So, ito yun. OH negative. Can you predict kung ano yung magiging reaction mo, Josh? What do you think is the possible product? Mali yan. Yung CH3 mo, wala dapat siyang color. Dapat dun lang, around lang sa C. Medyo blue. So, kasi yung mga CH3 non-polar yan, right? Hindi yung buong molecule mo. Kasi malaki yan, yung molecule mo yan. Parang ganito siya.
It's impossible to react.
Hindi.
It's
impossible to react. Meron yan.
I have a genius idea.
Why?
I have no more genius idea.
Okay.
CH3 behaves like an H atom anyway. It will form an aldehyde.
Vanishing bed. How could you do that, ano, Josh? Yung parang ano lang siya? Oy, hindi yan aldehyde. Mali!
Why? You cannot form.
Hindi siya ano. Ako sa bagay, wala pa kasi tayong organic. I'll give you an idea na lang. Sige na ako na sasagot, ha?
Ako na po. So, ganito po. Magda-double bunch po sa sarili niya.
Hindi. You're doing ano? You're doing the least possible na structures.
There is an ang dinino pa carbon is actually called cyclomethane.
Hindi. Bonding with itself. Okay. What can you say about bromine? Highly electronegative, electropositive?
Electropositive. May electronegative.
Okay, good. So this is partially negative, right? Partially negative. So this bromine is bonded to your carbon atom, right? So burahin ko lang to, itong hydrogen, ha? Tapos gagawin ko siyang literally nandito din. So, mali. Bromine lang yung red. Si bromine lang yung red, Josh.
Ang bawal?
Si bromine lang. Sige. Lagyan mo ng color lang muna si bromine. Kasi remember, non-polar si ano eh. Non-polar yung ano mo eh. Ito oh, non-polar yung mga yan eh. Okay. Ngayon, if that is the case, Josh, what is the charge of your carbon here? Yan ha, may mga review ka na ng chemical bonding tsaka chemical structure. What will happen to your carbon here? Partially what?
Partially.
Say bromine is partially negative.
Partially negative. Partially positive.
Partially positive. So if that is the case, if this is partially positive, Josh, medyo kind of blue siya. Yan yung lalagyan mo lang ng blue ng onte.
Natanggal, sayang.
Hindi ko nga alam kung bakit natatanggal. At hindi ko nga alam kung paano mo siya nagagawa eh. Saan yan yung change mo? Sa line width?
Hindi po. Yan sa dito po.
Sa draw. Yeah, sa draw. Yeah. Right. Ito. Wait. Sa draw, tapos ano yung ano, i-click? Yung parang
yung rectangle. Yung parang sticker po. Na wavy line.
Sticker. Ah, I see. Ito. Ayan. Ayan, nag-gets ko na. So, wait lang ha. Erase ko yan. Okay, good. If that is the case, Josh, if OH, di ba, hydroxide ion, ano yung, what can you say about the hydroxide ion? Full?
Negative.
Full negative ito. Full negative. So, in which part of your molecule, ito ha, in which part of your molecule will your OHP attracted? So by the way, ang name nito ay 2-bromopropane. Yan yung name niyan, 2-bromopropane. 2-bromo, hindi lang pala maayos, burahin ko lang ha. Again, habang binubura ko, Josh, in which part of your molecule will OH be attracted?
Yes, sa bromine po.
Yung OH negative mo ma-attract sa bromine?
Positive.
Anong charge yung?
Ah, negative.
Oh. 'Di ba? You think of the ano?
Positive ba na po tong blue na to? Dapat negative. Baka double yeah. Red lahat.
So, partially positive. So, your OH will be attracted to this carbon. So, if that is the case, may mangyayari. So,
it will rearrange?
Hindi naman siya may rearrange. Ah, mamaya, may kita mo ha yung reaction. Then, tell me kung ano mangyayari. Anong reaction kaya yung nangyari. Carbon, tapos this carbon is retained. Tapos ito yung hydrogen mo din. Another CH3. So, instead of having bromine, this time, naging OH na siya. Tapos, naiwan na ngayon to.
BR early died.
BR gets free. So, na-freed na siya from your 2-bromopropane. Ano yan? Anong reaction yan? Tingin mo, Josh?
Non-exotic.
Uy, na, ano natin yan? Hindi, anong type ng reaction? Tingin mo?
Substitution. No, substitution.
Very good. Tama. Substitution reaction yan.
Ah, po. It will BR will be replaced by OH for something. All the BR is more clean.
Okay. So, my next question here is, direct kaya yung reaction nila? Like, kunwari, si OH, magbubungguan lang sila with 2-bromopropane, and then, you'll form this one na. 2-propanol. This is 2-propanol eh. Ayan, conversion to. Tingnan mo, Josh, ha? You are now converting one substance to another substance na organic. Right? Alkane ito kanina. Alkyl halide rather. Diba alkyl halide ito? Kasi meron kang ano eh. Ito yung ano naman. This is the nature of organic chemistry. Converting one functional group to another. And you now form an alcohol. Hoy, 2-propanol is isopropanol ha, Josh ha? Ito yun, isopropyl alcohol. Ibig sabihin, if you have 2-bromopropane.
Isopropanol. Imagine saying isopropanol.
Ibig sabihin, Josh ha, if I have 2-bromopropane, I can convert that pala to isopropyl alcohol when I add NaOH. And that is happening. Pwede yun.
So this okay, means so, I will collect a lot of this and then I will put laundry detergent in somewhere. And then I will just simply put yung ano po, I will just simply put in yung ano nga po, yung laundry detergent nga po.
And then what will happen?
Will it form? The question is, will it form isopropyl alcohol?
From detergent? You don't have to do 2-bromopropane sa mga detergent.
You will put bromopropane. Will it form?
Sa detergent?
Abo.
Yeah, party. Meron at meron yan. Kasi ang detergent mo, magpo-form yan ng mga OH negative eh. Basic kasi yan eh. Yeah, party. Meron at meron ka mabubuong 2-propanol. Okay? Might be may mga side reactions ka kasi detergents naman are not purely puro NaOH lang eh. May mga stearate ka nga dyan, etc. Anyway, balik tayo. Tingin mo lang, is this reaction direct? When you say direct, your OH will just collide with your 2-bromopropane and then you'll form your 2-propanol.
Yes.
Direct ba siya? Okay. Of course, the answer po ay, experimentally speaking, Josh, this will occur in a two-step mechanism. Kaya nga sabi ko sa'yo, gusto kong ma-appreciate mo yung kinetics kasi may application talaga siya. At ang application niya, one application is in organic chemistry. Very, very vital. Saka nakaka-idea ka na with mechanisms. Okay? So, two-step mechanism siya. So, what is the first step? In this, ano ha, in this scenario, Josh, ha? Ang first step natin, Josh, ay ito talaga. CH3C and then CH3. So, simplified ko na lang to, ha, Brumi. Tapos, ganito siya, Josh, ha? Yan. Tapos, mabubuo mo ngayon to. Plus, ito. Ano nangyari dito, Josh? Itong band na to, ano nangyari sa band na to, Josh? Lahat siya ay napunta kay Nino. This band.
Napunta sa si... Wala. Nawala.
Nawala siya, pero... Where are your electrons? Because bonds are made up from electrons, right?
It went to the CH.
It went to the CH?
Naging
kasi positive. Naging positive siya eh. Oh, eh, electrons yun, right?
Where? There's no bond here. There's no bond here. Where? It disappeared.
It went to the bromine.
What?
Ayan, no? Ito oh.
The bromine is bonding with itself.
Hindi naman. The bromine is getting all the electrons.
Hindi pa, the bromine is bonding with itself.
So, okay. So anyway, may explanation dyan kung bakit pwede mangyari to. But this is your first step. Okay, what can you say about your first step? Slow or fast? Ayan, ina-apply natin siya ha. Slow or fast? Again?
Slow.
Slow, why? What is the reason?
The bromine is breaking a bond.
Mm-hmm. And the reaction is actually in equilibrium.
Oh, it's so equilibrium. There's a double arrow.
Ikaw talaga, hindi mo napansin agad. Sabi ko sa'yo, di ba? Be mindful with the arrows. Okay. And then, once you have this, mas madali na lang to, right? Kasi you can easily appreciate this eh. Di ba positive na to ngayon, Josh?
Abo.
So, mas madali na lang siya ngayon magre-react with OH to form, di ba? To form your ideal product. So, this is fast. Ayan. So, this is the actual mechanism for SN1. That's SN1 reaction. So, anong tingin mo? Take a guess, Josh. S stands for what?
S stands for fast.
No, substitution. Tapos, oh, N stands for
nucleophilic. That is the SN1 reaction. Those are the books, whatever that is.
Yes, correct.
SN1, SN2. What are those?
Ayan yun. Mechanism yun.
I thought po they were like barcodes or something. This
no, they are not barcodes.
I will check it up in PubChem and then I can see this is his ID.
Actually, you're quite advanced because you're reading SN1 and SN2 already, but you don't know, right? SN1 is a mechanism. SN2 is another mechanism as well. Both of them are substitution reactions. Okay? Both of them are substitution. Malapit mo na itong malaman kasi organic na ang next mong topic eh. Organic chemistry na. So, SN1 reaction or SN1 mechanism. Okay? So, SN1 mechanism. So that is an application ng kinetics, right? So it's very important for us to take into consideration the chemical kinetics of reaction because we can clearly understand what is happening dun sa reaction. Tingnan mo, Joshua, an idea. How can you form 2-propanol from this mechanism or how to make it as so? Possible, pwedeng mga ganito yung i-consider mo. Instead of having bromine, Josh, why not have iodine? Para si iodine or iodine, mas mabilis siyang mag-break apart from the bond itself. Kasi si I negative ay mas stable kaysa sa Br negative, right? So you can have an idea kung paano mo siya mapapabilis.
Pero or mas magiging... Kung ginamit ko I negative, hindi nyo na pa pumakita yung
I negative. Oo nga, no? Kasi Ang I negative ay wait, anong color ni I negative? Ah, yeah, colorless yata ang I negative eh, no? Sa water. Mm-mm. Kasi ang I2 ang may color. So, mawawala ngayon si I negative diyan. Or actually, mas stable kasi si I negative compared to your PR negative. Okay? So, that is your SN1 reaction. I think we're good for this one. So, stop share ko muna.
No. Ayan.
We're done. Actually, we're done, Josh.
Oh, no.
So, tignan mo, ha? Babalikan ko lang tong slide na to.
No, I don't want to
see. Appreciate mo. You want to appreciate this, definitely. Okay, I'll let you see. Oh, we're done with this one, ha? So, reaction mechanism is a very important part ng kinetics. So, if you will see here, umikot tayo more on the reaction rates, Josh. So, yung mga reaction mechanisms kasi, wag ka mag-alala, yung buong organic chemistry, laging may reaction mechanism. So, you'll have an idea for reaction mechanism for organic chemistry. And then, tignan mo yung next slide, Josh. Next slide. What is this? Summary.
Yes, I need to take a picture of this.
Or summary of...
Ito?
Ah, meron yan. Meron yan. Nasend ko to sa, ano, sa dad.
I need this.
Okay. Oh, sige. You need this. Sige, you take a picture of this so that we can have a formula. Parang summary of formula later. Using your phone, ha? So, ayan. Summary of ano. Ayun, natuwa siya, sir, kasi nagbabasa na pala si Josh po ng mga organic books or may mga siguro nabasa siya na SN1, SN2. Akala niyo po mga barcodes. No, those are actually mechanisms. Okay, so SN1 is a mechanism. So, it's a substitution mechanism for organic.
Kaya nga po, ano, talagang pag kami magtuturo, mapapabilis yung learning na po.
Mm-hmm. Tsaka ito lang. Tsaka ano, na-introduce ko na kagad, like sinabi ko, ito Josh, yung diniscuss ko kanina sa whiteboard, it's actually part na ng organic chemistry. SN1 okay. Mechanism na to.
Kaya po itong mga videos na to, very valuable na kasi dati kami na sa med, wala pa kasing technology ng ganito. Ano, audio. May nagre-record po eh.
Oh, sounds.
Yung pinakamagaling magaling magsulat, mabilis, tsaka okay lang sa kanya kasi talagang gagawin niya.
Transcribe na lang, no? Gagawing notes. Kasi
share niya. Pero ito hindi na eh. Sabi ko, pati nga sa mga, kunyari sa music niya, sabi ko, i-record na nga natin para lahat yung ano, pwedeng balik-balikan.
Correct, pwede.
Tapos yung mga ano, mas na, ano po.
So, ayan, ito, meron na siyang idea po.
Yun sa mga videos po, ano, ini-review talaga namin yung mga ano yung mga itong mga videos na previous lessons.
Yep. Ayun po. So magandang ano, maganda talaga siyang method.
Introduce yung ano, hindi ay Josh naka-off original sound, baka may hinay ganyan.
Literally 1984.
And then wait lang Josh, ha? Next slide. I'll see you the next slide. What is the next slide, Josh?
Oh no! No! Don't save! It's the back rooms.
You'll be back to the concentration camps. Okay. I'll be sharing now. Tada! Your favorite files.
No.
Pag ang sinishare ko ay PDF, favorite parts mo yun eh. Favorite sharing. Wait lang ka, I'll be sharing this one. Okay. Ito, nakikita na po ba?
Opo.
Kaya pala sabi niya, sir, na-gigi yata ako pong gumawa, na-excite kasi gumawa ng mga tanong. Sabi ko, nung ina-analyze ko din, hala, parang ang dami kong na-send na question kay Josh about reaction kinetics. So sabi ko na lang sa kanya, okay lang yan, at least, ano, you have a complete, ano.
Maybe.
Oo nga po, eh, talaga, ano eh. Tapos, talaga parang mahasa po eh, no?
Oo, yun po talaga yung, ano, parang sabi ko, ang goal naman natin is, for Josh to learn and, learn and parang absorb everything. So parang I'm exposing him with a lot of questions na rin. Para, sabi ko nga po minsan kasi, ang mga students, the more na familiar sila sa type ng questions, kahit anong type ng question yes, questions yan, Josh, mas better. Kasi they will move around the same concept.
Yes po. Okay?
Pero the way you ask questions is also another factor.
Ayaw
the
po.
More na mas na-exposed ka sa iba't ibang type ng questioning, mas okay.
Yung pagkaka-phrasing. Di ba iba-iba po yung pagkaka-phrasing?
Yes.
Oo, kaya depende. Kaya ako, kunyari po, magbibigay akong problem, hindi ko papalitan. Kung may nakita akong problem, hindi ko papalitan na maintindihan. Kasi ganun, ibig sabihin, ibang tao, ganun sila magsalita. Di ba po?
Correct. Yes. Parang kahit parang ma-expose ka na, Josh, ng kahit anong type ng problem dyan, you can always solve that. Parang, kasi they will just move around with the same concept. Eh. They will just ask differently. And if you will see here, Josh, integrated ngayon siya. Sabi ko sa iyo, di ba, yung mga stoic, yung reactions, gases, they are just part na lang ng ating mga topics ngayon. That's the reason why very important that you really know the previous topics. Sige, makikita natin yan later. Anyway, let's start. So, letter A is ways of expressing chemical reaction. Ito, very easy to.
Very easy. Hopefully.
Let's see. Sige, I'll not stop sharing na lang. Mamaya, share na. Kapag nagka-calculate na tayo, you share your screen na. What's your answer for letter A? Sige, sulat mo na.
It is the book in the...
Exactly in the slide, right?
It's in the slides.
No, right lang. Right lang the relative rate of appearance and disappearance. So A is will be very easy. Ayun, akala ko makakalimutan mo yung negative A, negative 1 over
A. Kala niyo po.
Okay, good.
Hindi na po ako malilito din. What happened? Nawala! What? Yes.
Sorry. Ayan na. Hindi, andito siya.
Ayan.
Just continue. Ayan, nag-unstable na naman kasi yung connection ko. Kaya enough ko muna yung video, Josh. Okay, good? Okay, that's correct. So, can you tell me, Josh, why do you have a negative sign for A and B?
Because they are, I don't know, I think they are reducing in concentration.
Okay, good. So, because they are disappearing. And then, what can you say about the stoichiometric coefficients? Dapat you take the...
Hey, sir, saan ito? Sa practice set na pala tayo, no?
Ah, yes po, sir.
Ay, pwede po natin, next video po, bale.
Ah, and, okay. Para kung
okay po yung ano niya, yung...
End of the first na. Ay, sayang!
Tawag po kay Elit.
Para... Ulitin mo na lang yun later.
Ulitin mo na lang, Josh.
I-stop ko na po yung recording.
Stop recording na.